I'm going to see Allie next week for her birthday. Allie is my girlfriend that I met in Spokane over the summer. Honestly, like, I really don't really know what to get her because, I mean, we're still trying to get to know each other a little bit better. So that's why I brought my siblings along to help me pick out something for Allie.
What's her favorite color?
Blue.
Okay, blue. Yeah, no. What does she like besides farming and pigs?
She's like an outdoorsy person. She likes to...
So no jewelry.
She likes more jewelry. Yes, she does.
What's your budget?
$100.
$100.
Nice. So out of us girls, who is she more like?
I guess. You.
Me? Okay, so shop for me. Alex, the baby. I mean, I'm surprised. The first convention that, you know, I decided not to go to, the baby of the family comes home with a woman. I mean, a woman. I thought this chick was 18, but she's only 15. He brings home a woman, and he's happy. Look how cute. He's so cute.
Okay, that's not a good fashion walk. Okay, no, turn around.
Hey, Alex, you should get her this.
That's what she should get her.
And this lunchbox, too.
She should use it.
No.
Emily, you look like you're in the fourth grade.
You don't want this, Alex?
No, I mean, yeah.
Alexia. Yeah.
Allie lives on a farm. I don't think she's quite obsessed with tractors like how I was when I was little. I think she's just more around them because that's what her family does.
You were a great model, Emma.
Thank you. I know I was.
And I think she's a medium.
Just because these shrink a little bit.
That's her next to me.
You think? Okay.
But Allie and I both have the same kind of dwarfism, a chondroplasia. She has two average-sized siblings, and her parents are average-sized, so she's the only little person in her family. Yeah, and she's super sweet and everything, and I want to get her the right gift.
Does she like silver or gold?
Oh, we don't know like that.
I don't know that.
Okay, what would you rather, silver or gold?
This is
I'll say silver.
This is just our birth month.
Yeah, let me see it close.
Look how it is.
Oh, no, great.
Sorry about them.
That's okay.
Silver or gold?
Alex, look. That's really pretty.
That's a simple.
You could put yours on there.
Yeah, I was saying, Alex should put his on there.
Oh, you put yours on it, and then y'all's dating
month. That's
what I
was saying.
Yeah, that could work.
Right?
Yeah. Sure.
No, I'm seeing what y'all
doing. They started dating, and then his birth month. How about that?
So cute. Aww, that's cute.
Should I do that one?
That's something she would wear.
Yeah, put those back. That's cute.
I think that's
cute. That's very cute.
So the first thing I got her was a shirt that has her initials monogrammed on it. And the next thing I got her is this necklace that has both my birth, is it birthstone?
Yes.
Okay, yeah.
Birthstone's birthstone.
Yeah, it has my birthstone, her birthstone, and the month that we met each other, which is July.
Yeah.
And then the last thing I got her was this nice little keychain thing.
Yeah,
yes. Because she's 16.
Yeah, because she's 16 and she's a new driver, so I thought this would be cute for her.
And she likes blue.
And she likes blue, so this would be nice for her keys.
Thank you. I appreciate it. I hope she'll enjoy all of her gifts.
Oh, she will.
Have a good trip.
Thank you. Thanks, guys, for y'all's help.
You're welcome. We love you.
Our little brother. Our little boy.
Alex.
What?
Hey. What are you doing?
I was playing.
When was the last time you talked to Allie?
I think last night.
You ain't talked to her at all today?
Well, I mean, we snap each other, but I mean, but yeah, we're... Because, I mean, we both have school, and she has to work on her farm and everything, so we're both busy.
Alex's trip to Ohio is coming up, and, you know, this is a really big deal because, obviously, he's going up to Allie's house, her and her family's home, and going to stay there for the weekend, which involves spending the night and, you know, all that good stuff. So it's important that we, you know, just kind of remind him of
good
respectful
choices.
Rules. You've got everything that you need for your trip up to Allie's?
Yep. So I'm going to see Allie on her birthday. I'm going to be flying out by myself up to Ohio, and now it's just only less than a week away.
We got the suitcase bag.
Yep.
Because I'm trying to make it where everything will go in it, so he don't have to worry about
beds.
With the overhead beds or checking
stuff on.
Or
that's
going like to
be
that.
Too much.
Boarding an airplane, the only struggle sometimes is the overhead bins. It's not always a struggle if there's a flight attendant available to help you. If not, we have no problem standing in our seat or another passenger seat to put those luggages up, the suitcases up above.
He says that he's going to be good going through security and stuff by himself. But he's never done it by himself, Trent.
I have to admit, I am a little bit nervous flying by myself because, well, the Atlanta airport is huge, and plus, just the fact of me flying by myself is scary in itself.
When you do something by yourself like this, you pay more attention to detail and where you got what you got to do and where you have to go versus when you're walking together as a group and you're following mom and dad, you're looking at your phone, you're looking around, you're spaced off, and all you're doing is making sure that mom and dad are somewhere in front of you and that's where you're following.
First time we ever have any of our children fly by themselves?
I'm not worried about Alex in Atlanta's airport because there's security everywhere and Alex knows that airport.
Well, I worry about the flight too.
And then you board when it says anybody that needs assistance, blah, blah, blah.
I board. I know that. I've done that with y'all many times.
Yeah. You can for multiple reasons. Because you're under 18, you're a little person.
Honestly, I think mom is honestly more nervous than I am because, I mean, yeah, I'm nervous, but I mean, there's a really good end goal, so I know I can push through it.
Obviously, you know, you were, like, raised with rules and morals and all that good stuff, but when you go somewhere, just like when you go to a friend's house, you pretty much take on their rules.
Right.
Well, I just reminded Alex that, you know, hey, you respect the rules of their home or their, you know, do's and don'ts and, you know, because you're in their home.
No sitting on the couch with blankets over both of you. Can't do that.
Hands need to be in sight at all times.
Okay. I wasn't even thinking about that, but okay.
I know you wouldn't. That's why we don't have to worry about you, Alex.
Like, especially in the beginning of dating, we could not, you know, have them, like, in the bedroom, like, our bedroom. And then we had what was called an Emma and Alex, especially us who were dating when we were younger. We had an Emma and Alex that would also be in the room, too, sometimes.
But if her dad comes in there and just randomly sits on the couch, he's not interested in what y'all are watching. Alex is a fine young man. He's very respectful. He's a good kid. And
he's very much a rule follower.
Yes, we have no worries or struggles.
Five times to get one of those, but we got one. He is a rule follower through and through. Thank God, because...
Just getting to know each other, spending quality time over quantity time. You're not going to get to see each other every month.
Right.
I'm just here to tell you, that ain't going to happen.
If you wanted to tell your 16, almost 17-year-old something when he's going to his girlfriend's house for the first time, it's simple. You just say, make good choices. I made good choices. Made other choices, but I made good choices, too. Look, before you can go get the sugar, you can look at her and go.
I'm not sure sugar isn't the question, but I mean, I'll pack it just in case.
We said...
I don't want to figure out, Dad. I don't want to move too fast.
Yeah, exactly. What are the plans for you guys this weekend?
So, I mean, today, like, we're just going to go to, once I get there and, like, I meet up with them, Allie said that we're going to go to dinner tonight and so I can, like, I guess just chat with them and get to know them a little better.
Yeah. Today, I am taking Alex to the airport for him to fly completely solo to see his girlfriend, Allie, in Ohio.
Not gonna lie, the anxiety started kicking in last night. Thank God, took melatonin. We were all been up all night.
Like excitement or true anxiety? Like you're
both,
worried?
A little bit of both, honestly.
What are you worried about?
Mainly just, I guess, the Atlanta airport, mainly.
Okay, well, I mean, I can talk to you through it, too.
Right.
But once you go through the train, remember, you go to the train, you get off at sea gates, you get off the train, you go up the escalators, and then you look at the numbers up on the big signs. It'll say, like, C1 through 30 this way, C31 through 50 this way. I'm extremely nervous. This is my first child traveling alone, but it's also my youngest child. Like, I'm not quite sure why we waited for the youngest one to fly by himself.
I think you're gonna do fine.